With her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Okay. The years start coming and they don't stop coming. Dun, dun. Okay. What was that? Hi, guys. Sorry, I was just continuing the song. Then, hello. Oi, oi, oi. Hi, hi, fat boy. We're singing. Thanks, big bro. According to all laws of aviation, there is no way a bee should be able to fly. Its wings are too small and to get its fat little body off the ground. The bee, of course, flies anyway because bees don't care what humans think is impossible. Exactly. Well, hi, Cantlem. Hi, fat boy. Hi, Silent. Hi, big bro. Hi, Crouton. I hope you all are doing well. It's so good to see you all in here. Hi, Brad. I know. I'm sorry I was a little late. It is from the Bee Movie. I like that movie. Did everyone have a good Sunday? Did everyone have a good Monday? You're excited? Me too. I can't wait to see what happens. Thank you so much, King Crunchy. Welcome in, my friend. Trying to imitate the bee dance. I can't do that. Okay, guys. Doki Doki. Hello. Thanks. Aww. That's so sweet, big bro. Guys, I'm feeling so good today. This is the best I felt in a long time. So it's so nice. Yo, Jetman, how are you doing? And Cantlem, finally going to do the festival. Yes, I'm sorry. I tend to be a slow playthrough kind of player, so I appreciate you bearing with me. You're pumped? Let's go. You, welcome in. How are you? Just relaxing a bit before bed. Nice. I lurked like your entire stream. I'm so sorry I didn't say anything. I just hung out. I hope you don't mind. Oh, you might be getting PC parts. That's awesome, Crunchy. Let's go. You can share that here, Cantlem. Kiro, I love you. You're gonna take credit for you feeling. Yes, exactly. You're back. Welcome back, Crouton. Hola. ¿Cómo está? I don't really speak Spanish, so like, if you respond in Spanish, I won't know what you say. That's like the only exciting. Hey, no, Cantlem. First of all, thank you so much for feeling comfortable to share that here. Bien, good. See, I do know some Spanish. Look at us. Look at us go. You might use them. That's awesome, Crunchy. Cantlem, I'm really happy that you felt comfortable sharing that here. And I think it's really awesome that you took that step to take care of yourself, because actually I've been talking about self-care in the Discord server. I think self-care is really important. I'm not building a computer. I already have a really nice computer. You can see the picture of it in my panels, in my about section. ¿Por qué no saves? Saves. Oh. Why no? I don't. I don't know what you're saying. How I have missed you, big bro. Yatu saves. ¿Qué te gusta los juegos? ¿Qué? Why? For what?
What?
Also, because of the company I work for, even though I'm laid off for the winter, it's free. Ooh, that's fantastic, Cantlum. Congratulations. Let's start off the game. Or let's continue off the game. I swear I just started drinking this. It's been a long day. I'm still feeling the best I have in a long time. Before we go way too into it, I didn't want to talk about that. So I have been sick lately. Not like sick, but like not great. I saw you down at that after every word you took a sip. Not sick of you. But today I'm feeling so much better. I was able to work out today. It was really nice. And like I ate. Okay. You guys ready? I ate 3 meals today. And one was not coffee. Sick. I love that. I ate 3 whole meals and you are allowed to say it. No bastachu? And hi, Rax, sit down with the sickness. Yes. I know, 3 meals. 3 meals plus snacks. And I had a protein powder and I ate my vitamins and I drank water. I know. And I had the energy to work out today. Let's go. Yeah. Right, Poggies? Let's go. Thank you for the bit silence. Y'all ready for this? And you didn't gain 1,000,000 pounds, almost like it's healthy or something. I know. I do struggle with that. I am working on eating and exercising, but not eating enough so I can exercise. But welcome in, I can't say your name. Ooh, who the fuck? Who deemed bacon? Crunchy did. No, you can say it though. I appreciate you asking, Cantlin. But I've had COVID, but not right now. Do 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 do. Thank you for redeeming that. No bustachu. No bustachu. No bustachu. Not bustachu. This is going to be a hard one. Can we come up with a nickname for you? Can we do that? Like, what's one that you would like? This is your time to reinvent yourself. What's your nickname? Big bro, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Nurse QT appears, I'm glad. I took a collagen protein powder. I don't know. And an apple cider vinegar thing. The supplement, because I am not drinking that stuff. It's nasty. I don't know if it's placebo or what. I know it's not completely placebo because, trust me, if it was placebo, I would not. Busty? Let's go. I'm good with that. Let's go, Busty. Okay. It can, I think. That's what they say, right? I don't know. Maybe it's just some big internet hype thing. But honestly, I avoided everything on Amazon that said it went viral on TikTok because I'm like, You guys got a Warzone win without me? Wow. Wow. Now I know what the problem was every time. Me. Ginger is good for the stomach. So no, Cantlum, okay. The reason I have to talk before. I am sorry, crouton. It'll be redeemable soon, okay? So just hang in there. Caitlin, so I have to talk before because it's all talking and I can't really talk in between or it gets weird with this story. So I was sick. I have celiac disease. I've been really low energy lately, just not feeling well. And, okay, Crouton. But Yakuti is the problem. She wasn't playing her best. Oh, okay, okay. BT is going for nuke. Yes, okay. I'm so proud of you. It's so hard to. It's so hard. And I'm so proud of you for doing that because I know I had a really difficult time doing that. So as long as we get... Same, Crouton. Same. No, you guys were just holding me back. Okay, big bro. But I'd been feeling really tired. I've been having headaches. I've been like... Yeah, I can't have gluten. So it was a rough time. I just have not been feeling good. Been in a really bad slump. And I'm getting out of it, I think. So I think one of my problems was I was pushing myself too much, exercising too much, but not feeling myself. So I'm feeling a lot better now. Yeah. Oh man, crunchy thing. I'm feeling better today. I have to say, just, I wish that feeling better was like a constant incline, like always consistent, but it's really not. It's not linear. It's very much day by day, just based on, because that's how it is with autoimmune stuff. But it's okay. I do my best. And I think I'm finding some things to implement in my day that will help me avoid getting as bad as I did get. I'm going for walks at work. I have the opportunity that I can walk around. Thanks, Silent. That was really hard for me, to be honest. Right, at least I feel better than yesterday. Yay! Hi, Luke. Good to have you in here. A good walk at work is always good for everyone. Yes, I have a wonderful coworker who's walking with me, and I really appreciate it. Now the hype begins. Let's go. And yes, Crunchy, very similar for me. As long as at least I feel better than yesterday. Today was a really good day, and I'm hoping for the same thing tomorrow. So I'm going to repeat what I did today while also listening to my body. Y'all ready for this? No worries, Luke. You have a good night. Do what you gotta do. Lurk, all that fun stuff. Okay, you guys ready? We will begin. All right. Thank you guys for always listening and for the love and support you always show me and helping me take care of myself. I really appreciate that. Okay. Speaking of taking care. Good. And I'm happier knowing that you took some time for you today. Okay. I guess I've gotten pretty used to handling her at this point. I'd like to recap. We're talking about Sayori, and we are about to work on a weekend project with Yuri for the festival on Monday. But who knows I am a boy named Briciusss in this game, okay? All right, moving on. But who knows what might end up happening when we're outside of school. She even told me she was looking forward to it. I shake my head. Why do I feel nervous that Sayori finds Why do I feel nervous that Sayori finds out about this? It's not like we feel that way about each other. Besides, like Monica said, this is about the club. If you'd like it, Life Strange and maybe another game called Coffee Talk, not quick. I'll look into it, Caitlin. Thank you for that suggestion. I have nothing to worry about. If I just go with it, then I'll have a good time. Okay, let's see. Ooh, I'm sorry, Crunchy. Yeah, I hope you get whatever you need figured out. It's already Sunday, imagine. I've been getting increasingly anxious about Yuri's upcoming visit. I keep telling myself there's no reason to be nervous, but it doesn't help much. Yuri is clearly an introvert and an intimate person in general. There's no doubt that she'll open up a little bit when it's just the two of us. Meanwhile, we've even been texting occasionally. She was extremely apprehensive at first, but it wasn't long before I was already learning more about her. But putting Yuri aside, I haven't heard a thing from Sayori since she left the club early the other day. It's not like we text each other all the time or anything, but I've been worried about her in the back of my mind. Between what Sayori said and what Monica said, it is really okay for me to put Sayori's feelings aside when she might need me. No, Log Splitter, I'm flirting with some anime girls and gonna get me an anime girlfriend. What do you mean? Weird time for the music to stop. Once I get better insurance, I will... Five sure be switching over. I hope you can, Crunchy. I decide to visit Sayori before Yuri comes over. Rather than asking, I simply tell her I'm coming over much like you've done in the past. Once I reach Sayori's house, I knock on the door before entering it myself. Again, we used to play so often that we've made it a habit of simply entering each other's houses like we're family. The house is quiet. Everybody in comp is an anime girl? Sick, let's go. Sayori isn't anywhere on the first floor, so I assume she's up in her room. By the way, hi Log Splitter, I hope you're doing good, and I hope we can catch up soon. And thanks for stopping by the stream. We'll have to play. I'll play some comp with you soon. If you're up for it. Definitely. Okay. Sayori isn't anywhere on. I gently open the front door. So I assume she's up in her room. It's already strange of her not to run down and greet me. I head up to her bedroom where I finally find her. Sayori? Hi, Briciusss. I sit down in her room. Sayori forces a smile, but it's easy to tell that she's different. Oh, I love you, QT. Get some rest. Proud of you. Proud of you. It's 11. Good job. Someone sounds like a creeper just entering someone's house. You mean like how you would enter someone's house? Got him. Sayori forces... Oh, but it's that she's different. There's a minute of silence between us. You haven't come over like this in a long time, have you? I guess you're right. It's been a long time. Not much has really changed, has it? Sayori's room is as messy as it's always been. I also recognize the same stuffed animals and wall decorations that she's had for years now. If you came over more often, it wouldn't be such a mess. That's because I end up cleaning it for you. How come you suddenly wanted to come over today? Aren't you supposed to see Yuri today? Yeah, but... Wait, how did you know that? Sayori had already left by the time we decided that last meeting. Monica told me. It's only natural for her to keep me informed about the festival preparations, right? Ah, that's true. Oop, hit the wrong button. You only play Nuke? I said I'd play comp with you. What do you mean? Sorry, I'm trying to... No, Bryce, this is playing a creepy boy. I am playing a creepy boy, huh? Hi, creative. Welcome in. Ah, that's true. But what about you? Aren't you going to be helping Monica today? Of course. But I'm just helping her online. We didn't plan the meetup or anything. Ah, so it's just me and Yuri then? Yep. There's more silence between us. Siri stares in a random direction. Everything about her behavior is really uncharacteristic. I finally get to the point. I just wanted to see how you were doing. After you left on Friday? When something's wrong, you can't hide it from me. I know you too well. So, Siri smiles, shaking her head. That's no good, Briciusss. Eh? Why can't it just be like it's always been? This is all my fault. If I didn't get so weak and accidentally express my feelings, if I didn't make that stupid mistake, then you wouldn't have been so worried about me at all. Mine too, big bro. You wouldn't have come here. You wouldn't have been thinking about me right now. But this is just my punishment, isn't it? I'm getting punished for being so selfish. Why? Why is she saying these things? I think that's why the world decided to have you come over today. It just wants to torture me. Why is she laughing? Right, Sayori, are you okay? Sayori! I grab Sayori by the shoulders. What on earth are you saying? Are you listening to yourself right now? I know something happened to you. There's no other explanation for you to be like this. So tell me already. Until I know, I won't be able to stop thinking about it. Siri gives me an empty smile. Annie, are you okay? Are you okay? Are you okay, Annie? You really put me in a trap, Briciusss. But you're wrong. Okay. Blakey boy! I've missed you! Welcome in! You're in France? Thank you so much for 8 months sub! Let's go! How are you? ~100% Bree is coming out? What do you mean? Oh, I feel better. Is that what you mean? Sorry, enough of this, you're a lovely, beautiful, sweet girl. Right? Exactly, Cantlum. Listen. You're, huh? What? But welcome in, Blakey boy. Thank you so much for the 8 month sub. I hope you're doing well. You have been missed. Ooh, can you tell me about it? I've always wanted to visit. Okay. Okay. So, okay. Back in the story mode, Sayori just said that I'm what's wrong. Nothing happened to me. I've always been like this. You're just seeing it for the first time. Seeing what? What are you talking about, Sayori? You're really just going to make me say it, aren't you, Briciusss? We all know what she's going to say. But apparently the me in the game is just too oblivious to these things. Okay. I guess I have no choice this time. The thing is, I've had really deep but really bad depression my whole life. Did you know that? Why do you think I'm late to school every day? Because most days I can't even find a reason to get out of bed. What reason is there to do anything when I fully know how worthless I am? Really sad. Why go to school? Why eat? Why make friends? Why make other people put their energy and caring to waste by having them spend it on me? That's what it feels like. And that's why I just want to make everyone happy. Are anyone worrying about me? Dang, I knew what she was gonna say. Did not make that easier. I'm in shock. I can't even figure out how to respond. How is it possible that Sayori kept this from me the entire time that I've known her? That she really wants so badly for me to just not think about her? Why, Sayori? Why is it that you never told me about this? I think I have a mental health command. That's a good idea, Caitlin. It almost feels like I've been betrayed as your close friend. Okay, that's kind of like selfish. Don't say that. I don't like that I said that in the game. I'm like mad at game me. Because if I knew, I would have done everything I could to support you. I get that, but even if there's only so much that I could do, I would have tried a little bit harder to make every day a little better for you. That's why I'm your friend. Yeah. You had a hotel overlooking the tour. The Eiffel. Ooh, the Eiffel Tower. That's awesome. Well, if you don't mind me asking, what brought you out there? Just a trip? Okay. All you had to do is tell me. You don't understand at all, Briciusss. Why do you think I didn't tell you? Because if I told you, then you would have to waste effort caring about me instead of doing important things. I don't want to be cared about. It's bittersweet when people try to care about me. It feels nice sometimes. It also feels like a bat being swung against my head. So I wanted so badly for you to make friends with everyone else. Helping everyone be happy together is the best thing for me. Then I discovered something else too. Your wife is French? Wait, hold on. So, this is an intense part of the story, but also Blakey boy. When did you get married? Last I knew you guys were engaged. When did you get married? Because that is so freaking exciting. Congratulations. She did say earlier she likes bittersweet. Yeah. Because Blakey boy, that's fantastic news, and I'm so happy for you. That's really exciting. You have not been in here much, my friend. I'm not trying to call you out or anything, but you haven't been around in a minute. But for good, very good reason, you got married. Congratulations, I'm so excited for you. Oh my gosh. That's, yay. Hey everyone, throw some hype in there for Blakey boy. The newlyweds. Okay. So, back to the story. Thank you, Hale. Sayori. But then I discovered something else, too. I spent a month in France, so my time to... No, it's okay! It's okay. Thank you for the bit, Silent. That's so exciting. Congratulations, Blakey boy. Y'all ready for this? I did say hype. And you brought the hype, so thank you. Okay. Now we know the other thing she's going to say. Okay, Sayori. But I discovered something else, too. Seeing you make friends and get closer with everyone in the club feels like a spear going through my heart. So that's why. That's why I decided the world just wants to torture me. Every path leads to nothing but hurt. I can't even do the little laugh. You're right, that I don't understand. I don't understand your feelings at all, Sayori. But I don't need to understand. Whatever it takes for me to help you stop hurting, that's what I'll do. No, Briciusss. There's nothing. Nothing at all. The only thing That could have helped me as if everything could be like it always was. But I was selfish. I finally showed you what a horrible person I am. Tears streaked down Sayori's face. I made you join the literature club because I was selfish. And I was punished by my heart hurting in a way that I couldn't understand. And now you came here and I made you hurt too. I'm just weak and selfish. No, Sayori, stop saying these things. That's all I am. That's why I'm going to accept these punishments. Because I deserve every last one. Without thinking, I once again grab Sayori's shoulders. This time I pull her into a tight embrace. Exclamation point hug. Sayori, please. Exclamation point hug. Yes, hugs in the chat, please. I'm so sad right now. Thank you. So, here. I'll show you guys. Yep. Exclamation point. Hug Sayori. Just put a space in there. Just put a space. You're good. You're good. You got it. Briciusss, Sayori, I don't care if you feel selfish. I'm really happy that you convinced me to join the club. Seeing you every day makes it worthwhile enough. Hi, Julian. It's so good to see you. I'm sorry. It's a very emotional, very sad part of the thing, but welcome in. Thank you for look at all those chickens. All right. If I make friends with everyone else, then that's just a bonus. It's okay, Julian. Don't be sorry. Don't be sorry. I just feel bad I wasn't as welcoming as all. But please, never underestimate how much I care about you. I wouldn't have it any other way. Briciusss. I can't stand the whole name thing. It's throwing me off. Sayori isn't hugging me back. Despite my arms being wrapped around her, Sayori's arms remain at her sides. She starts sobbing next to my ear. No, don't do this to me. Please don't do this, Briciusss. I feel awkward now. Sayori barely manages to speak between her sobs. I don't know if I'm doing the right thing, but all I want for her to know that I care. If you have it and need to call yourself selfish, then you have to let me be selfish too. No matter what it takes, I'll figure out what needs to change. Yep, warning. Thank you, Cantlem. Thank you, Cantlem. I appreciate that. No matter what it takes, I'll figure out what needs to change. I'll make these feelings go away. And if there's anything that you need me to do, then you'd better tell me. I'll get mad if you don't. That was me. That's me. That is me. That I know it's me. But like, Cantlem, I agree. Thank you. I'm not crying. You're crying. Right, big bro? When she was talking about her feet, like how she feels when she's depressed, I was about to lose it. Not gonna even lie. Not gonna lie. Okay. I don't know. Gently, Sayori finally puts her arms around me in return. I don't know anything. It's all really scary. I don't understand any of my feelings, Briciusss. The only time I'm not feeling nothing is when I'm feeling pain. But your hugs are so warm. And that's really scary too. Sayori lets me go. As she does so, I let her go as well. The festival is tomorrow. Yeah. It's going to be fun, right? Yeah. How would you like for me to spend it all with you? It's what I want. I promise. I I think that would be nice then. Yeah. Hit right in the feels, big bro, I'm telling ya. Siri wipes her eyes. If I could spend the whole day here, I would. Of all days, this has to be the one where I have other plans. Maybe I should cancel. No, don't! Please don't. If you did that, then I really wouldn't forgive you. Right, young love? But it's almost time for Yuri to meet me at my house. At the very least, do you want to come along and help out? It would be fun. To my surprise, Siori shakes her head. I'm sorry. I don't know if that would be very good for me today. You understand, right? It's kind of hard for me to fully understand, but I'm trying my hardest. It's okay. Don't worry too much about it. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? All right. I look forward to it. Welcome in, Rubu. I say goodbye to Siori and exit her house. On the way home, I find myself still feeling uneasy. But it's hard for me to keep thinking about it when Yuri is about to come over too. I think Siori is right. I shouldn't be worrying too much, and we're definitely going to have a great time tomorrow. I should just focus on what's ahead of me. As I approach my house, I see something that makes me feel a moment of panic. Yuri? Thank goodness. You're a little early. I'm sorry I wasn't home yet. Were you waiting for a long time? No, I just got here. But I started to get really nervous when nobody answered the doorbell. You always could have texted me. Where are the parents? I just curious. If I had known, I would have reassured you and hurried more on my way home. I suppose that's true. I didn't think of that for some reason. It should be common sense to do that, but I decided to ignore it. Anyway, let's go inside. That's a nice house though. Where is parents? Where are the parents? I see you brought a lot of stuff with you. That's right. And did you manage to find everything I asked you to buy as well? Yeah, pretty much. At least I hope I got everything right. I'm sure it'll be fine. I take Yuri to my room. The first thing she does is glance around curiously, which makes me feel anxious. It's so clean. I cleaned it before you came over, so... That's very considerate of you to do. No. I would be really embarrassed for my room to be a mess while you were here. Well, I do enjoy cleaning. I would have gladly helped you clean. Yuri is so sweet. That is so nice to offer. That would be even more embarrassing. I feel you on that, though. I feel you on that. Wait, don't look in there! I snatched Yuri's wrist. Sorry, I'm just thinking like it's a closet full of like all the stuff he shoved in there. Anyway. Oh, it's a desk drawer. Sorry, I snatched Yuri's wrist, which was in the process of opening a desk drawer of mine. What's in the drawer, dude? What's in the drawer, man? I'm sorry. Right. I wasn't thinking for some reason. I was just spacing out. It's fine, it's fine. I let go of Yuri's wrist. She puts both of her hands firmly in her lap, as if making sure she's keeping track of them. She just goes, I'm just gonna stay right here. Right, what was she looking for, Caitlin? But what is he hiding? You know what I'm saying? What is he hiding in the, what's in the drawer? Some dirty magazines. So, should we get started? Yes. I have a few things planned that you can help with. Right, cotton 4K, Julian, that's what I'm saying. Decorations and other atmospheric enhancements. Atmospheric enhancements? You know, mood lighting, aromatherapy candles. What is she, what atmosphere is she going for? Interesting. In the words of Gunther from Friends, put the mouse back in the house. Right. Oh, wow. I didn't know you planned on taking it that far. Of course. I want to help take our guests to a faraway place. Although many will stop by just out of curiosity. And for cupcakes, I guess.
I love my break!
Panda Lit 124, welcome in. Thank you so much. Guest? Right. Silent. Okay. I'm determined, so welcome in and thank you so much for the follow. You just watched my lurking video? No way. And you came here? So you came here from the TikTok? Came here from the clock app? Thank you so much. Thank you. Welcome in. Okay, chat. What's in the drawer? Was it A, his dirty magazines, as Bree said, B, his tribute to Yuri, or C, mystery box? Ooh, I'm going D, and it is anime, and he got embarrassed. I don't know, actually. I think A. I'm going with dirty magazines. But welcome in. I don't usually play games like this, but I hope you enjoy it. It's really interesting, and trigger warning, there is a lot of sensitive topics that we brought up. Mental health issues, stuff like that. So, fair warning, if you are not in the headspace for that, I invite you to come back for my drawing stream on Saturday when this game is over. D, furry hentai. See, creative, we're on the same wavelength. That's the kind of dirty magazines I'm thinking. I'm like, he's like, you can't look in that drawer. You know what I mean? I agree. I think creative's got it. That is totally fine. Okay, cool. So if you're not familiar with this game, just that's a fair warning, okay? And if it is any, it is much at any time, do not feel the need to stay here. You can go ahead and take the time you need, but I am drawing on Saturday. Welcome in. I really appreciate you coming from TikTok. A lot of our friends here are from the TikTok app. All right. So Yuri says, I'm determined to provide an experience that will leave them wanting more. That's great. Easy to forget that you're a pretty intense person. Intense? Like camping? I guess that's the best way to put it. Is that a bad thing? A and D, hentai anime and porn. Right, exactly. Yeah, exactly, big bro. But there's also cupcakes, right. Tribute to Yuri and D. No, not at all. It's something that I like about you, actually. Is that so? That makes me feel relieved. And kind of happy. Yeah, no need to be so anxious. You can relax a little. Relax. I brought some things for relaxation. Thank you so much for the biddies! Y'all ready for this? Yay. Thank you so much for the bits. I'm sorry. I have my... Usually my camera is down there. Like down at the bottom of the screen. But because the text is there, I didn't want to block the text. So now my alerts cover my face. And I think that's a good break for everybody. So I've just left it for now. No worries. All right. Relax. What is that? I was going to use them during the poetry event. Oh yeah? Like what? Let's see. Yuri rummages through her bag. She pulls out a few candles and a wooden cylinder-shaped object. I did some shopping on the way here, so I happen to have these in my bag. I plan to cover the windows in black paper and use the candles to light the room. I think that would be amazing, don't you? Yeah, that would be really neat. What's that wooden thing, though? Oh, this? It's a diffuser for essential oils. How familiar are you with aromatherapy? Not familiar at all. Ah, is that so? It's one of my favorite contributors to a positive atmosphere. When does mom and dad come home? Right. Huh. What is happening here? Depending on the oils or herbs you choose, you can change the mood of the air itself. You can even feel it permeate through your body. Relaxation, positive energy, romance, reflection. It's almost like magic. Yuri takes a cylinder and pushes a switch on the bottom. Y'all better not say anything. In just a moment. Right? Why? Hey, Yuri, relax. That's a thesaurus word. That's a thesaurus word, right? Permeate. Yeah. Why does it all sound so wrong? Like, they knew what they were doing, right? They knew. They knew. When they wrote this. They knew, for sure. Alright. Thank you, though, for saying stuff, guys. Because I'm like, I can't be the only person. I can't, right? Relax. Switch on the bottom. Don't open the drawer. It's all on purpose. That's what I'm saying, creative. I'm like, I can't be the only person like this. So thank you for making me not feel so alone and being a horrible, terrible person about a anime game. Okay. In just a moment, a thin ray of vapor begins to sprout through a small hole on the top. Why you gotta word it like that? I don't understand. Wow, that smells wonderful. What kind of mood is that one for? This is a jasmine essential oil. Is this getting woo? Perhaps, I don't know. Right? I'm like, can we use different words? Please. It smells a little sweet and flowery, right? We're gonna try to hold it together, okay? This is the content warning I was talking about. You also smell wonderful. Was that the door? Be right back. Boy. Yeah. Okay. No, silent, don't say that. Yeah, that's a good way to describe it. I chose jasmine for the festival because it provides more than relaxation. Jasmine enhances your emotions and helps you feel them flow through your body. You feel warmer and your heart pounds more heavily. Okay, Blakey boy, get some rest. Don't you think that will be perfect for sharing our poems? It does sound suitable, but you seem to know a lot about this, so I'll trust your opinion with anything. Yuri smiles gently, clearly enjoying herself. She again reaches into her bag and pulls out several spools of thin ribbon. What are those for? Well, did you purchase the origami paper I asked you to get? Something going to be following soon. Yeah, I have it over here. We won't be using the paper for folding origami. What I'd like to do is write a different word on each paper. We'll need about 100 of them. Oh yeah? What will those be used for? Well, I'm going to cut pieces of ribbon to hang from the doorway of the classroom. Then we can fasten the paper onto the ribbons to create a doorway curtain. Wouldn't that be beautiful? It would also catch the eye of those passing by the room. It may attract some to peek inside. That's really creative. I had no idea you'd be so good at this, Yuri. Is that so? Well, I suppose I do get a little intense, as you put it. Yuri giggles with red cheeks. Is it just me, or is she more relaxed when it's just the two of us? Or maybe it's the excitement she feels from sharing something that she enjoys. Here's a marker, Briciusss. That's all I get. I get a marker. Oh, you can write any characters you want. I'll help you once I finish cutting the ribbons. Alright. Sitting on the floor together, the two of us get to work. I carefully draw a different character on each paper, doing my best to manage my bad handwriting. Yuri unravels a long strand of red ribbon to her desired length. Then she reaches into her bag once more and pulls out a pocket knife. Who could have seen this coming? They could have, Crouton, but they did not, did they? Intense was the word they chose, right? The knife is strangely beautiful. The silver handle has an intricate pattern of waves etched into it. The blade itself is gently tinted blue. That's no ordinary pocket knife. It looks really fancy. Well, embarrassed, Yuri looks away. What is it? You're going to think it's weird. Yuri, whatever it is, I have no reason to judge. Whatever's in that drawer, I'm telling you right now. Telling you right now, that's what he's thinking about right now. It's each their own, you know? It's a demon slaying pocket knife, let's go. I know Crouton is like, why you got a knife? why you have it? To each their own, you know? If you promise you won't be weirded out. The more she says that, the more I'm like, I'm gonna get weirded out. Did a funny happen? No. Nope. Welcome in, Snoop. How are ya? Yay! You got a blue star. Alright. The thing is, I'm kinda into knives. No kidding. No kidding. Who could have guessed? Who could have guessed? I'm worried about this one. Same, big bro. They're just so pretty. I can't help it. I don't know what it is. The combination of craftsmanship and feeling of danger, maybe? What am I saying? Sweet, thank you for the bit. Y'all ready for this? Danger from a pup. Get out of there, right? Red flag. Yuri loves blades. Exactly. Exactly. Please don't think I'm weird for this. Welcome in, though, sweetie. I hope you are doing fantastic. Ahahaha. You're laughing at me. No, I'm not laughing at you. It's just funny how nervous you got about sharing. It's an interesting thing to be into, I guess. But I think it kind of suits you. Getting KFC, let's go. Have fun, Cantlem. We'll be here when you get back. There we go. I'm doing pretty good, sweet. Just to let you know, so first of all, welcome in. This game, I don't know if you're familiar with it, it does get a little intense later, so if you are not prepared for that, please no spoilers, as this is my first time playing, but if it gets too intense, please feel free to step away from the game, a lot of sensitive subjects, so, okay, bear with me. Suits me? Yeah, it's kind of intense. Besides, it's a really cool looking knife. I can't deny that. It is, isn't it? Yuri relaxes her expression once again. AKA this part coming up is sad. Right, no emotional spoilers, thank you. Who is this? K1 Niffy? I don't know if I'm saying your name right, but thank you so much for a freaking raid. What the heck? Welcome in, raiders, for those who do not know me. I am Briciusss, and thank you, Silent. There we go. So, just tell me how I say your name. I would love to know, how was it, what did you play? Red Dead Redemption. Ooh, Vintage Cookie. Howdy. Welcome in, everybody. Kniffy? Kniffy. I think I can remember that. Kniffy. I'm sure you get like Knifey. I like that one. It can be your nickname. Just kidding. I'll go with Kniffy.
I love my break.
Thank you for the follow. Cantlem, do you know Kniffy?
I love my break.
Vintage Cookie, thank you for the follow. I can call you Kniffy? Perfect. If you pay the FedEx. Okay. So I'm not sure if you're familiar with this game. I love my brick. Yes, absolutely. Cause I love you guys and you are now a brick. So congratulations. Okay. So.
Oh goodness.
Not the yawns. Okay, please no spoilers. This is my first time playing. Again, content warning, it gets a little intense, okay? This game is not suitable for children, though it warned me multiple times. Okay. Yuri relaxes her expression once again. You're exactly, let's go, crouton. Would you like to hold it? Thank you for that, Vintage Cookie. How are you? Welcome in. Thank you guys for joining. What brought you here? If you don't mind me asking, what brought you here and how was your stream? How was your game? Please tell me. Please let me know. I hope you both had a wonderful day. Sure, I'll check it out. Yuri carefully hands me the knife with the handle facing me. I take it and turn it around in my hands. It feels heavy and extremely solid. Where do you even get a knife like this? Curious of its sharpness, I feel the point of the knife with my index finger. Ow! Briciusss! Why did you do that? I didn't expect it to be that sharp. I'm sure I've had this conversation in real life. I barely touched it at all. It's my fault. I should have warned you. This knife is extremely sharp, no kidding. It can cut through skin like it's paper. Oh no. A small drop of blood trickles down the side of my finger. Had a few viewers got raided myself, then got told to raid a Doki Doki streamer, found one guy, but he had just finished the game. Okay, well, here we are. Thank you though for raiding me, I really do appreciate it. Guys, if you scroll up, here, actually. If Roxa, if you are available, if you could shout out our new friend Kniffy again, I would appreciate it. Please go show this wonderful new friend who raided us. Let's go show him some love and follow. So, or like you can be like me and click the name and follow. And boom, there we go. Okay. Of course, here. I got you. There you go, guys. Okay. Who the fuck carries a very sharp knife around just to keep it at home or use a normal, not so sharp pocket knife? True, crouton. Yep. Of course! No problem. I also dropped a follow so that I can hopefully catch a stream sometime. Alright. Yuri takes my hand and gives the wound a closer look. She stares at it and noticeably fidgets. If you're squeamish, I'll go wash it off now. Without warning. What? I didn't just read that. No. No, Rogue, what the fuck? Without warning, Yuri puts my finger in her mouth and licks the wound. What the fuck? I feel her tongue curl around my finger. Startled, I instinctively pull my hand back. Please forgive me. What the fucking shit? This is hilarious. Why would they describe that? Because, Crouton, this game is trying to get in your head and show you how dirty mind you have, okay? That's what this game is doing right now. Excuse me. Right, Cantlem. Kids these days, big bro. What the fuck? Silent, like, wow. A quick one right there. That's true love, Rogue? I don't know. Bow chicka wow. Right. Creative. What was that? Candles and the diffuser cylinder thing. Yeah, weird. Don't, silent. Yes, suck that finger. Get it, Rubu. I'm just so surprised at that turn. That is not where I saw that going, I'll be honest. This comes from the dirty mind of its author. You are correct, Crouton. I wasn't thinking, Yuri says. No kidding. I support it. Hot, Rubu, let's go. Setting the mood and a thing for knives and blood. Possible vampire creative. I don't want to say I guessed it or anything. But we all know. Yuri lowers her head, her face burning up. Yuri. I don't even know if I can like take this seriously right now. That's the no kidding. Okay, sorry. I read ahead my eyes read faster than I do out loud. That's the most embarrassing thing I've ever done. How could I do something like that? I'm sorry. Sure, it was a little weird, and it took me by surprise. But I guess she was trying to help, right? No way I'm rationalizing this. I don't have a dirty mind. I'm just wondering why I just eat someone's finger full of blood. Yuri, I think you're overreacting a little. No, she ain't. She's not. I wish I was a nicer person. I guess I'm just not that nice. Like, someone licks the blood off my finger, and I'm just like, dude, you're totally overreacting by saying this is embarrassing. Look how cute Yuri is, twirling her hair and blushing. This is very confusing and weird. It is, Crouton, it is. She doesn't lift her head. What if she doesn't recover from this for the rest of the afternoon? I wouldn't. Like, how do you recover from that? Alright, you know what? This might be oh no.
I love my break!
Hulk's fat brother? Well, welcome in. How are you? Thank you so much for the follow. Well, your character might have liked it. No, great. No, don't even say that. Carrying around a sharp pocket. Okay. I don't know what's going to come next. So, this might be a stupid thing to do, but I'd do it anyway. I take Yuri's hand and lick her index finger in return. I haven't watched Wayne's World lately. That's a good question, though. Welcome in. I hope you're doing well. Great, if we all knew what direction it was going, but I was hoping I would be surprised. I need some more alcohol to process this. It's an innocent girl with a pocket knife. Absolutely never know when you might need it, right? Mm-hmm. Go ahead and do a shot for me, Silent. This scene is very sussy and very cringe. I like both. Hey, are you the guy that commented on my Twitter earlier about the Led Zeppelin quote? And if they wanted to make music that everyone liked, they'd be the Bee Gees? Is that you? Welcome in! Thank you so much for coming from Twitter! Guys, look at this. If you stream or if you put content out there, look at it. People come to your stuff. My socials are working. I'm over here having a cringe overload. I'm sorry, Crouton. If it's too much, though, I do suggest taking a break and returning if it is too much. But if you want to find out what happens next, then stay tuned, okay? Imagine coming here from socials. Raxa, imagine. Okay. I take Yuri's hand and lick her index finger in return. Briciusss! That's how she's gonna react after she just licked the blood off my finger? What the fuck? Also, weird. It's anime in Japan. We're lucky she hasn't. Kraiden, no! 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 Ma'am, what are you doing with that pocket knife? Why is that boy licking your finger? No, creative. It was so nice to meet you too, Vintage Cookie. Thank you for coming in from the raid, and I hope you have a wonderful evening. Go have fun with your car. That's awesome. If you do get a chance to come back, let us know what car you're working on. That's exciting. Okay. So Yuri is surprised I licked your finger in return. Did you really just do that? Now we're even. Yuri just looks at me like I did something wrong. I knew that would be a bad idea. If not for the sweet aroma of jasmine oil, the air would be extremely heavy right now. Nah, it still is. That is fair. They are even now. 2 seconds later. FBI, open up. Right, exactly, Croutons. I haven't seen one tentacle, so it's not so bad, right, Big Bro? My work here is complete. I have traumatized. I will never unsee what popped in my head when you said that. It's hilarious. That is so freaking funny, though. You're so weird, Briciusss. I'm sorry. She has the audacity to call me weird. She licked the blood off my finger. And like, licked all around my finger. What the fuck? Alright. Yuri giggles shyly. Yuri calling me weird? That's what I'm saying. I have no response to that. Where do you keep your bandages? Ah, a logical thing to say when someone cuts their finger. I don't think I need one, actually. It was a tiny cut. Look, it already stopped bleeding. I see. That's relieving. Isn't it for everybody? The tension is quickly lifted. We each resume our own respective activities. Y'all, this is... What kind of freaking game is this? I don't even... I watch Yuri's knife cut through the ribbon like it's nothing but air. You are so weird for doing that, but I just did that to you. Right, right. He has magical healing properties. I see. Vampire. That's a thing, right? They have magic, right? That's a thing. I think I read it in a book. I watched Yuri's knife cut. Oh, yeah, I already said that. Crouton, I don't know. I still am, like, nervous sweating myself. You know what I mean? So, like... Meanwhile, I continued to make progress on the paper. After we finish attaching the paper to the ribbons, we lay them all out side by side. It looks better than I expected and will be very effective as a door curtain. It looks great. Good thinking coming up with this, Yuri. Thanks. It's just something I saw online, really. Are we ready to move on to the next task? Yeah, let's do it. What did you have in mind? I'd like to create a banner. The shot's done? Good job. That's why I asked you to buy the paint tablets. Ah, that's right. One of the items Yuri had asked me to buy was a kit of watercolor paint tablets. We need about 6 cups of water to put each of the tablets in. Do you mind fetching those for us? Of course not. 6 cups of water. I'll be right back in a minute. Thank you very much. Oh, and just a little bit of water, okay? If you fill the cups too much, it'll be too diluted. Taking Yuri's advice, I decided to use small plastic bathroom cups rather than full-size glasses. Silent my first thought. Not even gonna lie. I put them on a plate to catch any paint that drips, then bring it back into my room. Yuri? Yes? I come in to see Yuri unrolling her sleeve, putting it back over her arm. Nothing. Your face is a little red. How do they go pulling out a pocket knife in front of someone normal and licking someone's bleeding fingers non-suspicious? I don't know. Is it too hot in here or anything? No, not at all. There's nothing wrong, so let's mix the paint. Yuri hurriedly dismisses me and takes it upon herself to unwrap the tablets, dropping them into the cups. So, I thought we would do something simple that would look very nice. I'd like to paint a gradient across the banner, starting with the colors for a sunrise, then daytime, then sunset, and nighttime. Nah, they're just mixing up the watercolors. It's fine. But like, it is really suspicious. Like, what? Why did she have her sleeve unrolled? I'm worried because there's a really sharp knife that cuts skin like paper, and she knew this. Why was the sleeve rolled up? I'm just speculating here. Once it dries, I'll write an inspirational quote across the banner. We can hang it on the wall behind the podium at the front of the classroom. Ah, neat. What are you going to write? Well, it'll be more fun to surprise you. Yuri smiles at me. If you say so. After rolling out the banner, Yuri and I kneel on opposite sides so we don't get in the way of each other. Yuri uses a brush and adds a few dots of different colors across the banner to serve as a color guide when we paint. This kind of reminds me of elementary school. Painting on a banner with watercolors feels a lot like the art class projects we had back then. It's relaxing. I'm sorry if this feels too childish. Creative, yes. The situation is very... Oh, yeah. Crouton, you're not wrong. You're not wrong. No, I didn't mean that at all. It's kind of fun, you know? Yeah. It is fun. I'm glad you feel that way, too. Yuri stops painting for a moment, thinking to herself. For me, I don't need to go out and do crazy things to have fun. In fact, I usually don't even want to. I just like when I can spend time with one other person. Even if it's something simple like reading, it doesn't even matter if we don't talk much. Just having a friend next to me makes me feel a little bit nicer. That's so sweet, Yuri. I think that's all it takes for me to be happy. Is that so? Even if Yuri and I are quite different, I can understand where she's coming from. I feel that way about things like anime and games, where simply sharing the experience with someone can make me happy. No worries, Crouton. Have a good lurk. Murder, suicide, she's not going out alone. Guys, so... Okay, remember, like... sensitive topics, okay? But, Big Bro, I also had that thought process. Like, it's... I feel like we're heading that way, you know what I mean? No, it's okay. It's just a little... lack of better terms. Intense. But I also thought the same thing, okay? So I can't even lie. Yuri was your number one. Okay, Rogue. Okay. I like Yuri. I do. But I think Sayori's my girl, okay? So... I'm torn. Truly. I think I feel the same way. Yuri smiles gently. I knew you'd understand. Yuri leans over the banner to grab an unused paintbrush. Okay, Caitlin. Yo, we all have the same taste. Preach, B, I feel the same way. I move at the same time, causing my head to bump into hers. Typical. Right. Kaya! I'm sorry, I don't even know if I said that right. I don't make these anime noises. Sorry. Yuri reels back and I quickly lift my hands in surprise. Are you hurt? No. Ooh. I can't really say it like the ooh. That's the most you're gonna get from me. You just need to add. Hi. No, I'm not hurt. It just startled me, that's all. Sorry, I should have asked you to get it for me. Crouton, you're already back. Welcome back. I think I could. That was a damn fine ooh. Well, thank you, Big Bro. No worries. I'm like, I don't know. Can't love you, okay? You doing all good there? What about DDLC short show or film or something? Kaya Kyoshioka? Yeah. Five freaking gifted subs! Thank you, Big Bro. What the heck? Way too kind. Too nice. I need Becky voice for the ooh. I don't know what that is. I don't know what that means. Hype, let's go. Oh. Ooh-woo? Is that... That was it. You told me it was a good ooh. Well, I'm glad it was a good ooh. Okay, my face is like, I feel really red right now. Please don't, Crouton, no. I am. We could exchange channel points for Uwu. Oh, clip. Crouton, I'm sure it'll get clipped. It's fine. All in favor. My job is done here. Of course. Ah, your face. There are droplets of paint on Yuri's face and neck. Is there something on my face? Yeah, I accidentally got paint on you. Sorry, it's totally my fault. I'll get a towel right away. I rush out and fetch a small towel, then I dampen it with hot water. I return to my room and kneel back down in front of her. Of course, always the embarrassing parts of stream. Yeah, got a little bit of stuff to get through before end of stream. Okay. Here. I pat down Yuri's face and neck with the towel. Ah. Is something wrong? It's hot. I just didn't expect it. Sorry. I didn't want to use cold water. Having finished, I started to retract my hand. Welcome back, Silent. Aw, right? But Yuri suddenly holds my wrist. Wait. Just for a little longer. It feels really nice. I keep my hand still against Yuri's neck. She looks into my eyes. It's an intense expression that I recognize from when she reads her books. Almost as if she's lost in a daze, enveloped by her own thoughts. She breathes gently halfway through slightly parted lips. What is happening? I am also thinking, is there a time crunch? I don't usually stream too late on weeknights because I gotta work, but creative. What's going on in here? Is it the aroma of the jasmine oil? Sorry. Is it the aroma of the jasmine oil giving me this dizzy feeling? Yuri's gentle fingers wrap around my wrist, sending a tingling sensation through my arm. And suddenly, her face seems to be much closer to mine than it was just a moment ago. As I was thinking in game face. Right. Yuri slowly pulls away. Sorry. I've been feeling a little lightheaded today. I didn't mean to space out. It's fine. The moment is over as soon as it began. Yuri picks up her brush again, but her movement seems clumsier, like she's unable to focus. I remain silent, forced to ignore the event that just transpired. I hesitantly retrieve my own brush and continue following Yuri's example. That should do it. I finish filling the night sky with white dots that look like stars. She's in a trance. I mean, can you blame her? I'm a catch. Come on. Looking at the banner as a whole, it's pretty and natural looking. I think it came out better than I expected. You could cut the tension in that room with a knife. Let's go, creative. I love that. Thanks, Silent. I think it came out better than I expected. I'm really happy with the results. A very specific knife. Exactly, Crouton. Yeah, me too. Are you going to add the lettering now? Not yet. It needs to dry first. That's true, but won't that take a while? Well, perhaps it would be to leave it here, then have you bring it in the morning. I can do the lettering in the classroom before our event starts. Is that okay? That's totally fine. Wonderful. In that case, I don't think there's any more for us to do here. Phew. You say that like you're glad it's over. Was I wrong to assume that you were at least enjoying yourself a little bit? No, it's not that. I'm just glad we managed to get everything done. I see. I am too. I was a little concerned about time. I need to start making dinner soon. Do you don't have any time left? I was secretly hoping we would have extra time after finishing the work. After that weird encounter, she licked your finger. What? No, she needs to go. Well, Yuri thinks to herself, I think it would be too irresponsible. I think it would be too irresponsible of me to wait much longer. I'm sorry. I was hoping there would be a little more time as well. It's probably my fault. Sorry for being such a slow worker. No, it's not your fault at all. And the important thing is that we got everything done, right? Yeah. So, I shouldn't be disappointed or anything. Gathering all her things, Yuri seems to look a little downcast. I understand why. It sounds like she rarely gets the opportunity to spend time with friends in a relaxed environment. New kink achievement unlocked. Creative, that's hilarious. Pokemon reference? Oh, okay. Antlum. But that doesn't mean this is the last time it can happen. Once Yuri packs up, I walk her out the front door. Thank you very much for having me today. No problem, I was glad I could help. Just let me know if there's anything else you need me to bring tomorrow. I will. Well then, Yuri fidgets. I guess I'll see you tomorrow. Wait. I kind of say that without thinking. What's gonna happen? About today. It's fine that we didn't have as much time as we wanted. Because we can do this again. Whenever you want, you can come over or we can hang out somewhere. I forgot you don't like going out much. As I stumble over my words, Yuri simply smiles bashfully. Anyway, you know what I'm trying to say, so... You're very thoughtful, Briciusss. Yuri takes a step closer to me, then briefly squeezes my hand. Achievement unlocked, sussy encounter. Yeah, right, crouton? Vampires are usually sad when they don't get to drink blood. There's a lot of stuff done without thinking today. I kind of like that about you. Well... Ah, what the fuck? Sorry. Well... How am I supposed to respond to that? But I don't even get a chance to as Yuri suddenly pulls back. Sayori! Hi, Briciusss. Sayori! Just... Now, we weren't... It's okay, Briciusss. I just stopped by to say hi. So his other girl is not going to be happy, right? Damn you, Sayori. No, Rogue Sayori is my girl. What do you mean? Come on. Well, it's nice to see you. Pick them both? Big bro. I like your thinking. Let's go. I'm sorry, but I'm already on my way to leave. Aw, really? That's too bad. I'm sorry. But we'll all be together at the festival tomorrow, so... So that's fine, right? Of course. Sayori beams. Yeah, so... I'll see you tomorrow. Clearly embarrassed, Yuri hurries off. Sayori waves goodbye after her. Sayori, I thought you didn't want to come over today. Well, I tried staying in my room. But my imagination was being really mean to me. So I had to come here and see it for myself. See what? What are you talking about? You know, how much fun you were having with Yuri, and how close you got to her. It makes me really happy that you've made such good friends. That's all that really matters to me. Tears start falling down Sayori's face. That's all that matters to me. Why am I feeling this way, Briciusss? I'm supposed to be happy for you. Why does it feel like my heart is splitting in half? Kirby minds, Nikolai. I mean, great minds, great minds. Come on. So you have one girl leave and another girl come over. I'm just a player like that. Don't hate the player, hate the game. You know what I'm saying? Now what's gonna happen with Monica? Truton, I don't think I'm gonna pursue Monica. But you know, I can't decide if she wants me. So I mean, like, you know what I mean? Why does it feel like my heart is splitting in half? Sayori! It hurts so much. Everything hurts so much. This would be so much better if I could just disappear. Don't say that. Sayori, don't say that! It's true, Briciusss. If I wasn't here, then you wouldn't have to waste your sympathy on me. You wouldn't have to put up with me being selfish. Monica was right. I should just... Monica? Monica was right about what? Sayori. What I said before is true. I'm not going to let this continue. Caring about you like this isn't the burden your mind is making it out to be. It's something that makes me happy. It's something that I wouldn't trade for anything else. So even if it takes an entire lifetime, I'm going to be by your side until you don't feel any pain anymore. But... Sayori looks away. I put a hand on her shoulder to reassure her. I'm scared, Briciusss. I'm really scared. What are you scared of, Sayori? I'm scared that I might like you more than you like me. Sayori. It's true, isn't it? I was weak and started to like you too much. I did this to myself. Briciusss. I like you so much that I want to die. Goodness. Okay. Y'all can't accept compliments. I did not thank you, Silent, for doing another shot. Monica next on the list for you to get. Exactly. That's how I feel. And that's enough, Sayori. I don't want you to hurt anymore. I slide my hand down Sayori's arm and squeeze her hand in my own. Do you remember how I said I always know what's best for you? Do you still believe me? Wordlessly, Sayori nods. Even if you don't understand all of your own feelings, I know what you need the most right now. And that's what I'm going to give you. We're going to confess our love to Sayori. Sayori, I love you. Those are my true feelings. So there's no way you could like me more than I like you. I should have realized it sooner. $1 million. Nah. Right? I know, big bro. Sayori's my girl. What do you mean, Caitlin? Come on. Okay. Anyway, she's crying. How can I not say that I love her? Come on. I'm just gonna let her be sad. That's okay, Silent. No, Monica will be just fine. Sayori is who matters here. Come on, guys. With spending time with everyone at the club, making new friends, and having fun with you every day, it helped me realize that you are truly the most important person to me. That's why I'll accept any of your burdens, as long as we continue this every day, with you by my side. Yeah, Caitlin? Okay. That's okay, Rogue. I'm telling you guys, it's okay. It's okay. I made my choice, alright? Then I know we'll both be happy. Briciusss. Oh, I have brown hair. Now I get to see what the back of my head looks like. Woo! Young love, you want it? Young love, you want it. You want it all of the time. No going back now, right, Rogue? Suddenly, Siri wraps her arms tightly around me. Okay, Crouton. Briciusss. Is this really okay? Yeah. I hold Siri in my arms and pull her closer. You'll never have to let go of me again. Aw, that's so cute. I love you, Briciusss. I want to be with you forever. That's so cute. Me too. I feel Sari's grip around me weaken a little bit. What is this? Sayori? I'm supposed to be happy right now. I always thought this would be the happiest moment for me. But why? Even now? Why won't the rain clouds go away? They're not going away at all, Briciusss. It's okay, Sayori. It might take some time for things to get better again. But no matter how long it takes, I'll be there every step of the way. That's all that matters right now. Oh, okay. I trust you. Siri and I slowly release each other. So, I guess that makes the festival tomorrow our first date, huh? What are you saying? I don't want to think about those things, you know? I want everything to be the same as it's always been. Even if we really are a couple. I don't know if I could handle anything more right now. It's really new and scary for me. I understand. We'll go at whatever pace suits you best. How polite! Oh, hi! That's a dangerous statement. What do you mean? So, you hear that song. Serious status, depression almost abolished, confidence building. Right, Crouton? Hi, Corm. Welcome in. I hope you're having a good night. Hey, Briciusss? Sayori gazes at me once again, smiling sadly. Even if I get really, really sad, this is the best thing for me, right? I don't really understand what Sayori means by that. Oh, I trust you? Silent, don't be skeptical. No. Been an interesting day. Ooh. Share if you need to, okay? Tell me about your day. Or if you just kind of want to forget about the day, I understand that too. I don't really understand what Siri means by that. Are you saying that this is making you feel sad, Siri? I don't know. I don't understand what I'm feeling. I felt like a bunch of thorns when you told me you love me. Ouch! But that's why I want to trust you. You know what's best for me. Yeah, I do. That's my promise. I say that, but in reality, I've never felt more uncertain when it comes to Sayori. I know that I love her and she loves me, but I'm having as much trouble understanding Sayori's feelings as she is. Even though I can comfort her, I keep wondering if I should be doing something more or something different. I know these thoughts will continue to plague me until things are back to the way they were. Is that what Sayori means by not wanting anything to change? I don't know.
Who are you people?
Leon, no way. How was your stream, my friend? Welcome in, welcome raiders. How was The Last of Us, part one? Ooh. Sealed Sunset. Welcome in. Thank you guys so much for joining. For those who do not know me, I am Briciusss. Thank you. You guys are bricks now. Intense. I know. I love my bricks. Let's go. Thank you so much for the raid, Leon. I hope you're doing well. Guys, please follow our friend Leon. Leon is a wonderful human being and you would be lucky to follow him on Twitch, okay? It's what I was had to get go do some gymnastics with a client today. which was no big deal, but I totally fell for the front desk gal. Oh yeah? You haven't had a crush in a couple years? Aww. Cute, Corm. I love that. Steeled Sunset, no way. Thank you so much for the follow. You're a wonderful human being. The brick wall grows, yes. Please don't spoil though for her. This is my first playthrough of this game. So if you know anything about it, please do not tell me. Also, thank you, Sealed Sunset. You're adorable. No spoilers, right. I mentioned something about Siri IDK, if you saw. No, what did you say? I'm so sorry, Cantlem. Raxa, delete this if you think it so. If I'm allowed to bring this up, going back to the very start of the game, my childhood friend, she started walking up later and... Right. Right, yes, thank you, Steel. That's exactly what I was about to go into. She's also a photographer as well. Corm, what a catch. What a catch. You got her number, you got the digits. You find her Facebook. Do people do that anymore? Do people find like each other's Facebooks and add each other? I don't know. What's the hip new trendy things people do? I don't know. It was just as you got a raid, so the message I read it, Cantlem. Thank you. I did. I went and read it. But yes, trigger warning. There are some sensitive kind of ancient. No, I felt like at least 85 years old saying that sentence, so I feel that, Leon. Crouton. I have W Riz. Exactly, not yet. A couple of your friends work with her. So you're saying there's a chance. But yes, there's a trigger warning. If you feel like you cannot handle things that are possibly like negative mental health issues, such as depression, stuff like that, even heavier things, I don't know much. But please, if you feel like you can't handle that, feel free to join me on Saturday when I have a drawing stream. But the rest of the week will be for Doki Doki. But I also have to get her some data in regards to equipment anyways. So you're coming back. Oddly enough, maybe. Let's go. Corm! You're a catch. You're great. I'm wishing you the best of luck. And I'm really excited for you. I think this is going to go well. In-game, Briciusss seems to have W Riz with all the ladies. I do. I'm getting all the ladies. I'm getting all the anime girls. I could have like 3 girlfriends right now. I do have doggos. I have one. She's not in here right now. But when I see her, I will pet her for you. So thank you for redeeming that. No, I'm serious, Corm. Three girlfriends and maybe Monica too. No, Monica is the 3rd girlfriend. What do you mean? I'm smooth for them, ladies. Yeah, let's go. Okay. So, but I know I'll give everything I've got. So, we are going to recap. I just confessed my love to Sayori, okay? We are now together. Sayori is the most important person to me. And I'll do whatever it takes to have a happy future with her. It's the day of the festival. It was an intense dream. Leon, you okay? Right? Sayori is waifu for laifu. Yeah. Waifu for laifu. Yeah? Am I saying? Oh, I'm sorry, Leon. She's a pimp. Rogue, let's go. Aw, Leon. Of all days, I expected this to be the one where I'd be walking to school with Sayori. But Sayori isn't answering her phone. Don't know. I considered going to her house to wake her up, but decided that's a little too much. Meanwhile, the preparations for the event should be nearly complete. My girlfriend doesn't want to hang out with me, guys. I don't know how I feel. It's true, he did, but we had fun. Don't tell me. Last dab, hot sauce, Leon. The banner year and I painted is dry, and I gently rolled it up to take with me. She sent me a pleasant text reminding me not to forget anything, and I reassured her. Funnily enough, wait, Leon, you lit yourself on fire with a Molotov? Can't say I haven't done that, so I feel for you. I feel for you. Funnily enough, I probably feel the same way as Natsuki about the event. I'm more excited for it to be over so I can spend time with Sayuri and Yuri at the festival. It's okay, Leon. I understand. But knowing Monica, I'm sure the event will be great too. Oh, I've not played. You played what game? You played Fortnite, right? Oh, the last part of it. I've not played The Last of Us. Sorry. I've not played The Last of Us. I've definitely caught myself on fire in CSGO. It's very easy. Very easy to do. Who hasn't set themselves on fire? That's what I'm saying, Silent. What do you mean? It's such a solid interview process. Okay. Briciusss, you're the first one here. Thanks for being early. That's funny, I thought at least Yuri would be here by now. Monica is placing little booklets on each of the desks in the classroom. They must be the ones she prepared that have all the poems we're performing. Get silent. That's funny. In the end, I found a random poem online that I thought Monica would like and submitted it. Listen, Linda. Linda, listen. I won't jack Bryce's. No, you can tell. It's okay, Leon. I'm going to be reading. I've been waiting. This is a pinnacle part of the game. So we're going to go right on by. Arson, actually, no, I live in Cali. Arson is actually a problem. Right. 30 minutes. Thank you, Rexa. So that's the one I'll be performing. You can share your story. I just might not be able to respond right away, but you can talk amongst yourselves, you know? Okay. So that's the one I'll be performing. I'm surprised you didn't bring Sayuri with you. Yeah, she overslept again. That dummy. Mean. Your new girl. Okay. You'd think that on days this important, she'd try a little harder. I say that, but I suddenly remember what Sayuri told me yesterday. And I suddenly feel awful, knowing it's not nearly that simple for her. I only said it because it's the way I'm used to thinking. But maybe I should have gone to wake her up after all. You should take a little more responsibility for her, Briciusss. I mean, especially after your exchange with her yesterday. Monica knows. Monica knows. Long story short, I meant to throw a brick. Same, you know what I mean? I threw a Molotov. Honest mistake. Leon. I wish I was not the same way. You know what I mean? But yeah, I get that. Visibly panics. Is this like when your mother starts to count down? Oh. I used to... Oh. So not my fault someone put a wall in the way. Right. Monica got the eye of the tiger. Right, Kutan? He kind of left her hanging this morning, you know? Exchange. Monica, you know about that? Of course I do. I'm the club president after all. But I stammer, embarrassed. Did Sayuri really tell her about it that quickly? That we're a couple now? I didn't really plan on bringing it up with anyone yet. Jeez. You don't know the full story at all, so don't worry. I probably know a lot more than you think. Monica's being as friendly as usual, but for some reason I felt a chill down my spine after hearing that. Y'all knowing Monica. Leon after he's right. Yeah, exactly. Hey, do you want to check out the pamphlets? Way to change the subject. Okay. They came out. Sorry, I don't know why I said that weird. Came out really nice. Game, father. Hearts. I hope you're doing good, my friend. Super reassuring. Yeah, sure. I grabbed one of the pamphlets laid out on the desks. Oh yeah, they really did. Something like this will definitely help people take the club more seriously. Yeah, I thought so too. I flipped through the pages. Each member's poem is neatly printed on its own page, giving it an almost professional feel. I recognized Natsuki's and Yuri's poem from one they performed during our practice. What's this? I flipped to Sayori's poem. It's different from the other one she practiced. It's one I haven't read before. Get out of my head. 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 Should I really keep reading this? Steel Sunset. Well, thank you. Go all the way down. Okay. Should I read all of them? Monica digging up dirt, right, Silent? Okay. I don't remember where I left off. Get out of my head. 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 Okay, thank you. Get out of my head. Get out of my head before I do what I know is best for you. Get out of my head before I listen to everything she said to me. Get out of my head before I show you how much I love you. Get out of my head before I finish writing this poem. But a poem is never actually finished. It just stops moving. Thank you, Rogue. I think there's a pattern, but I can't tell. What is this? Silent, if that's necessary, then I think anyone should take the proper help that they need if they are having any issues. Has anyone seen, hold on, pause 1 second. Has anyone seen How I Met Your Mother? Right? Don't they say, so the crazier they are, the hotter they are, right? Isn't that how that works? I know you haven't watched it, Silent. Silent, you don't watch any TV. You don't watch anything, so we're moving on. So, crazy hot meter. You met my mom. I did? Nice. I'm sure she's a lovely lady. Okay. Reading the poem, I get a pit in my stomach. The hotter they are, the crazier they are. Shit, right? Right. Which is why I'm not crazy, guys. Sorry, that was a horrible joke. The hotter you are, the crazier you are allowed to be. Right, big bro. That's the real definition, right? Papa Sizzle. Hi, how are you? Yes, How I Met Your Mother. So we were saying I picked a crazy anime girl, I think. She's struggling, okay? Big brain. Mm-hmm. It was such a good one. I need to rewatch that. Have you guys? Okay, has anyone watched the Hulu original, the How I Met Your Father? I like Hilary Duff, okay? But I just don't know. What's a name on a brick? Is that the brick in Leandertiner's throat? Right. It's bad. It's cringe a little bit, I'd say. I hope that doesn't, like, make anyone upset. But, like, I like Hilary Duff. I'm trying to separate it from the two. You know what I mean? Yeah, Papa Sizzle. So I'll show you Steel Sunset. So I'm just going to call you Sunset for short. By the way, I love sunsets. They're, like, my favorite. So, I got distracted. Papa Sizzle, I didn't even welcome you in. Hi, how are you? It's so good to have you in here. I'm going to show you. It's my BRB screen, and your name goes on a brick. But I'm not going to be... I am going to be right back. So I'm not going to be gone very long. So just... I'll show you. You. So if you redeem name on a brick, the name goes on there. Thank you. I drew it and animated it myself. Actually, all of my stream art is drawn and animated by me. All my emotes, my panels, any banners you see, anything I post on my socials, my intro, BRB, and outro screen. What happens when I run out? That's a great question. That hasn't happened yet. But what I'm thinking is I'm going to make it an animated GIF, and I'm just going to have them fade between scenes and just have it, that layer be rotating and have it go from one to the other. So, yep, I think that's what I'll be doing. Honestly, I didn't think we'd get that far, you know what I mean? But here we are. Almost a year later. Holy crap. Oh no, they're channel points. So you don't have to use bits. So you just gotta hang out here a little bit longer and you can earn enough channel points to get a name on a brick. Yeah, Crouton? Thank you, Rogue. So this month, February 19th. Oh, wait, wait, hold on. Hold on, we gotta... Bryce? Whoops, I didn't even notice. Hi, guys. Brick's out of stock. It is? Oh, it's probably just on cooldown. Maybe? But Corm, you redeemed it. Thank you. But guys, so my one year of streaming and my birthday are really close together, and they're coming up. So in about a month, we're going to be doing a big... birthday, Briciusss birthday bash streamiversary spectacular. Let's go. Oh, I'm just noticing the names. Yeah, they're all you guys. So, right, I couldn't get all the letters right. Okay. Form, that was the goal. I wanted it to be. Absolutely ridiculous. I wanted it to be the most ridiculous name you could think of. Like, I needed it to be that way. It needed to be as crazy as, needed to be as crazy as the event. You know what I mean? I wanted it to be on brand. Ridiculous as us. Paul, now you wish your Twitch name was Brick. You're too kind. Bricks are fantastic. You are a brick, though. So you don't even need to be... You're Paul the Brick. You know what I mean? Like, you don't need that in your name. We just know you're a brick. Ridiculous is us. Exactly, big bro. I have a big surprise waiting for me. Too kind. Rexa, we are finishing what we need to until I'm going to bed. Briciusss big birthday bash streamiversary spectacular soon. Exactly, Crouton. Okay. Whatever. We're talking about celebrating my birthday, Raxa. Forever, Caitlin. Forever engraved in my stream. Reading the poem, I get a pit in my stomach. Oh yeah, the sad, sad poem. Briciusss? What's wrong? Nothing. The poem feels completely different from everything else Siri's written. But more than that, I changed my mind. I'm going to go get Sayuri, so... Well, alright. Try not to take too long, okay? I quickly leave the classroom. Don't strain yourself. Monica calls that out after me. I quicken my pace. What was I thinking? I should have tried a little bit harder for Sayuri. It's not a big deal to at least wait for her or help her wake up. Even the simple gesture of walking her to school makes her really happy. Besides, I told her yesterday that things will be the same as they always have been. That's all she needs, and that's what I want to give her. I reach Sayuri's house and knock on the door. I don't expect an answer since she's not picking up her phone either. Like yesterday, I open the door and let myself in. Oh, Raxa telling you 10 more minutes. You're okay, Sunset. You're not distracting you. Dang mods trying to take care of the streamers. This is Twitch still, right? You will hit a specific screen and you will know you're done for the night. Okay. It is, Rogue. Thank you. Okay. I know, I'm so scared, big bro. Sayuri? She really is a heavy sleeper. I swallow. Can't believe I ended up doing this after all. Waking her up in her own house? That really is something a boyfriend would do, isn't it? In any case, it just feels right. Outside Sayuri's room, I knock on her door. Sayuri? Wake up, dummy. There's no response. I really didn't want to have to enter her room like this. Isn't it kind of a breach of privacy? But she really leaves me no choice. I gently open the door. What the hell? Is this a nightmare? Has to be. This isn't real. There's no way this can be real. Sayuri wouldn't do this. Everything was normal until a few days ago. That's why I cannot believe what my eyes are showing me. I suppress the urge to vomit. Just yesterday, I told Sayuri I would be there for her. I told her I know what's best and that everything will be okay. Then why? Why would she do this? How could I be so helpless? What did I do wrong? Confessing to her? I shouldn't have confessed to her. That's not what Sayuri needed at all. She even told me how painful it is for others to care about her. Then why did I confess to her and make her feel even worse? Why was I so selfish? This is my fault. My swarming thoughts keep telling me everything I could have done to prevent this. I just spent more time with her, walked her to school, and remained friends with her like it always has been. Then I could have prevented this. I know I could have prevented this. Screw the literature club. Screw the festival. I just lost my best friend. Someone I grew up with. She's gone forever now. Nothing I can do to bring her back. Alright, there are no parents in this game! What? Ah, fucking shit. I'm sorry. Yeah, you remember when they were saying trigger warning earlier? This is what I was trying to warn people. No one told me what was going to happen, but I fucking knew this is what was gonna happen. Cantlim, I'm very much disturbed by what I just saw, but no, I didn't jump. I knew that. It's like Peanuts, these parents are totally parenting in absentia. Right. I didn't mean FaZe, I just mean you didn't look surprised. I wasn't surprised. No, you're okay, Cantlim. I expected that, unfortunately. You would claim these kids as mine either. I wasn't ready either, big bro. You would not. Damn. They gave us no warning for the next scene. Yep, it gets dark. I should have been more clear, I'm sorry. No, still sunset. So we've been warning people that it gets really dark. This whole time. It definitely hints to this. At least to me it does. I don't know if that's just because I've been through some shit, but I definitely knew that that was gonna happen. No one spoiled it for me. No one has told me that this is what was gonna happen, but I definitely knew that this is where it was going. So no, Cantlim, I wasn't surprised. And don't worry if you're analyzing. I just definitely knew that that's... The scenes are very sudden and come when you least expect it. I definitely expected that. Unfortunately. So there's nothing I can do to bring her back. Paul, I wish. Probably. So I think I'm gonna finish like this inner monologue. Yeah. Okay. This isn't some game where I can reset and try something different. I had only one chance and I wasn't careful enough. And now I'll carry this guilt with me until I die. Nothing in my life is worth more than hers. But I still couldn't do what she needed from me. And now, I can never take it back. Never. 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 End. Thank you, Sunset. Please, if you are struggling, if you are struggling mentally, please dial 988. It's okay, Sunset. It's okay. Well, it's really fucking shitty, huh? Does the game go on longer if I would have picked another girl? Like, I'm really confused right now. Sunset, I'm so sorry. That's really fucking sad. The game isn't over. Okay, yeah. Crouton, no! If anyone saw the title of my stream, that's really fucking dark. Oh my gosh. Me too, Sunset. You've been a delight. I'm done. Too soon. That is, I'd actually, yeah, for real. How do I save though? Hold on. Dang, imagine finishing this game on Valentine's Day. Ooh, that would suck. No, Crouton, it's okay. I am sorry that you just experienced this traumatic game with me. I see that. It's really fucking sad. I don't like that. So it's saved, right? I hope so. Okay. Of course, it's some fucking depressing lo-fi song in the background. Well, won't. No, it's okay. Well, it was so nice to meet you too, Sunset. Right? Well, that was a rough one. That was really sad. But may this be a reminder, if you are struggling, there is help out there. And it's okay to let people care for you. Even if you feel like a burden, okay? You're not a burden. And the world is a much better place because you are here, okay? I know. Okay, hugs for everybody in the chat, guys. Hug. Oh, I spelled it wrong, but you guys know what I'm trying to say. Thank you, Creative. You too. Thanks. I'm really sad. I knew it was coming, but I was sad. Thank you, Quorum. Hey, Mad World, right? But there is hope, okay? There is help out there. There are lines. You can dial 988, okay? And you can also reach out to the Discord. And if you need to privately message someone, I can do my best to respond. I obviously cannot respond to everybody, but if you are struggling and need help, and you don't know where to start, please, 988 is the hotline. Where you can post them in art. I think that would be a good place for them, or general, wherever you're more comfortable. But there's help out there, okay? And there are people who care about you. I care about you guys, okay? You are cared for and you are important. Just remember that, please. Okay. Well, it's sad. But Q, I would absolutely love that. If anyone, please, if you guys, thank you. I would love that. If anyone has some wonderful art or floofs in the Discord, there's a boopable floof thing. There, I would love to see art. Anything cheerful, happy would be great. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to watch some Avatar Last Airbender before I go to bed. So, all right. Good night, my friends. And I hope you all have a good night. Oh, I guess we can raid somebody. I think we can do that. Let's raid. Ooh, there's a wonderful friend that we get to raid tonight, okay? Paul, we're not. Don't even stress about it. It's a very wonderful stream friend of ours. Creative art would be a great place to put it. Thank you. She's a VTuber and a friend of our community, so... Yeah, so if you want to keep up with me outside of streams, please feel free to, you need to react to the rules with a brick if you can't post in the Discord. Is that what you mean? So if you want to keep up with me outside of streams, feel free to join any of those socials up there if you have them. If not, if you're kind of sick of me, I totally get you. So, like, don't even worry about it. Also, you can join me on Discord to get, like, the latest announcements. Again, I will not be offended if you mute my server because that's what I do when I join servers and just come and go when I need to. Same, sick of her. I am always sick of me. Yay, you bricked. All right. So copy and paste. So if you have a sub, you can do the dancing bricks. If you don't have a sub, you can do the purple hearts. Even if you have a sub and you want to do the purple hearts because you prefer it, go ahead. I'm good with that. It's there now. Hope you all enjoy. Ooh, I love animation. So yay. I'm excited. Okay, so we're going to raid this friend of ours. Please, please, please show love and follow. Yeah, so Q, you can, when I raid out, you'll see my outro, and it's an animation of mine. So I hope you enjoy it too. All right, thank you, my friends, and thank you for hanging out with me during that very difficult stream. And we will be playing more of this game Wednesday. So we should be finishing the game on Wednesday. So we will see how that all goes. And if it is too much for you, I completely understand. Wednesday and Friday. I'm sorry. Yeah. So Wednesday and Friday, I'll be playing this game. So... If it's too much for you, I totally understand. Good night, Leon. Thank you again for the raid. I totally understand, so feel free to hop in. I have a drawing stream on Saturday, which is going to be a lot more lighthearted. So I appreciate you all, and... Right, it'll be everything, I guess. So, all right. I appreciate you all, and sending much love, and I appreciate you guys. So, let's raid. All right. Appreciate you too, Rogue. Thank you so much. You take care. Night, Crouton. Bye, everybody.
Tell her that I wanna, I can't say I-